Hello, alright, welcome back. So we are doing, probably something, oh, we've already done this. We're doing Panzer Dragoon playthrough with the new music tracks. This is one of the main reasons I wanted to play this, so now we've got it in the game, let's just put it out there. See, I don't seem to be able to do the cheat menu anymore. Maybe they've reset it so you have to do the game again. It doesn't like me to do it. Oh, never mind. We don't need it to do the thing, but it's still disappointing. How about here? Unless it's A. I don't think it is, though. Right, let me just make sure. So the main reason to do this is the sound setting. So let's make sure original soundtrack is no, because you want a new one. Which I think it now defaults to anyway. Right, so we're just going to do it on something. I don't want any stress today. So. I finished it on hard, obviously, to get the menus and everything, but it's just an absolute bugger a lot of stages. I was clawing through with like the most bare minimum of health, so rather than having to redo stages on the stream, let's just try and do them all in one. One of the weird things, I don't know if it's a glitch in this game, is if you earn credits and then you reset, like, you restart your run, you just keep the credits. You could, like, play through a few times and not make it and just quit. And then you could have, like, 9 credits for the next run, which is kind of surprising. You don't need that. I'm just going to watch these because the new soundtrack is part of it as well. Yeah, so what's happened is like, I forgot the original composer of Panzer 1, and I think 2, is one amazing guy. We mentioned in the last stream. But the newer Panzer games was scored by Saori Kobayashi, I think is the name. And then she has redone the soundtrack for this. Let's bring it in line. Hello, alright, welcome, Holly. So yeah, they've re-soundtracked even these cutscenes as well. Might be able to notice if you're asking. Yeah, I'm jealous of you playing auto only because my copy is on the wrong region, so I can't just play it today. I'll have to get the old other Xbox copy. In fact, lean forward, it is here. I actually have it here, but yeah, it's not currently playable by me. Sponsored by coffee today. It's funny to think with all this quarantine situation, like, I wonder if I keep streaming and my hair just gonna be longer and longer and longer, and then eventually I'll be a wild man. So obviously I'm not gonna cut my own hair. It'd be quite a good like time lapse to put together at the end of all this. Just hopefully not that long. Just imagine the future where only my channel is survived on YouTube. For some reason, it's like a relic that someone's found on a hard drive, and then they just see, like, why did his hair suddenly grow during that time? We don't really understand that. My stream is the one of cultural significance that we kept, obviously. It goes without saying. Sounds so puny. They've actually redone the sound effects as well, which is surprising. I don't think that was a good idea, but because you can't turn them back. They got the original lock-on laser sound spot on, and now they've unlocked it. I think they've improved some of the other sounds, like the hit reaction sounds are better, I think. To their credit, they're patching the hell out of this game. It's like you patch multiple times a week. So. They've added in, oh, I can do a barrel roll as well now, but you have to be on low health, because I'm a normal at the moment. because I knew that was in Panzer. I don't know if it was in 1, but it was definitely in there. And now it's in here. It's so gratifying when you think, oh, wasn't that move in the game? You even remember the commands to press to do it, and then you're like, oh, I guess I remember it wrong, and then it turns out, no, you were right, and they just hadn't put it in yet. The sand with that blue dragon is such an iconic image. I love it. It's such just good contrast. Look at that. It's beautiful. Yeah, one of the main reasons I got the Panzer Water Disc out is so I can play it to stream Panzer, because it's got Panzer Dragoon 1 original version on the disc. So I'd love to. I wonder if it's on the Game Pass version. You should check that out. I wanted to stream that to show just how bad the graphics are compared to this. It's unbelievable. And at the time, we were honestly wowed. It was just like, this is unbelievably good. But it's like hard to even look at now. It's just like the most angular graphics in the world. I still love it, but it's just, it's amazing when you think about what you're wowed by. That's why Panzer Saga needs a remix so bad. Yeah. I mean, it's going to be. The artist doing the soundtrack just does incredible music all the time. It's like a lifeblood. I'm not surprised. It's great because it's like a new thing for me. Obviously, I know the game. Well, I remember most of the stages and what's happening, but to me, this is all new. Flaps. Yeah, cool. Check out. I think you might have to finish the game to unlock Pandora's Box, which I don't know what the requirements are, but you can unlock original Pandora. So good. When the Xbox original one came out, they had a load of Sega games like Jet Set Radio and Panzer. It was a dream. It was so good. Even Gun Valkyrie is really good. I'll probably stream that. But then they didn't get the success in Japan they were hoping for, even though they put everything into it. So they just gave up, which is fair enough. Like, they really tried to get all the best Sega development teams on board. Which is what I'm looking for. So. Yeah. Let's go. Episode Unos Dos Tres Cuatro. I loved it when you said you found your old original jank Xbox headset. I've still got that as well. It's just in a bag. It's like, this is so bad. But because they knew they had to give it with every console for free, I guess they just, that's the only way to do it. Like, make it really basic. I'm pretty disappointed with the new, it's so funny because I actually bought it from the powerhouse over here. The new Sony gold headset. Because although it's more durable, because the old one was like famously flimsy, it's not as comfortable. Like, I had it on for a couple of hours to play with Jim, and it really was getting to me compared to these, which I mean are not that much more expensive. The new Sony one, they've now gone for the like rigid durability route rather than the comfort route, so it's a bit of a, couldn't find a balance. Yeah, boy. Right. See, that noise is now seems longer. It wasn't perfect before, but it seem, and the lock-on sound is not as good. Like that laser sound used to be perfect. Anyway, because you could like try and get it. I'm gonna get this physical, so I guess if it's depatched at that point, you just not hold it. It's amazing how sometimes it is good to. Yeah, exactly, yeah. That's like the minimum they could get away with. I guess because only the voice was gonna come through the headphones on Xbox 360, not the music of the game, I think, because that would make sense. You only need one to hear, like, you don't need to hear someone's voice in stereo, but it's still not designed by any stretch. Oh, Plantronics, cool. Yeah, the original gold headset was so good, that's why I knew I had to buy the new one. You had to be very careful with it, because it was sort of disintegrating, but, yeah, it felt great. That was, like, the best headset I'd ever bought at the time. I never bought any third party ones. Apart from the giant Xbox. But yeah, the new one is it's just quite hard. My tender little ears now. At least the music works. And they've added in a few other things where you can do... oh, can I do dash as well? Yeah, you could always do that. But you can take the rider off if you just want to play with the dragon, which is quite cool as well. I think that was the original. Should remember. Hello, that's him. Everybody on is complaining to the devs about the turning speed, which is bad. Like, it's surprising how unresponsive it is. I was assuming it was just me misremembering the sound version of life. Yeah, sure. So I said, not much on the track of so I gave up on both. He's good. I'm learning a bit more about how the avoiding works. Tunnel section that really pays off. And the only reason, the only annoying thing about me not doing it on hard here is there is an extra boss. This thing is so bad at memory because we've just played this on normal. But it feels like this last boss has an additional form if I find out. It's not memory sign, but at least it's something else. Again, that I could have avoided that, but I just wanted to try and shoot it down. So that was the hubris damage I took there. One thing that is brutally, horrendously hard on this, the levels are hard on their own, but when you finish a level, you don't get a full health refill, you get like about half. So you mostly finish a level on no health, get filled up a bit, and then you might as well just die, because you know you're not going to get through a whole stage on like half health. I really want to see it run where someone does that, because I'm not. So even though I used to be an ace at this, I'm certainly no. I've actually found a glitch that makes one of the levels faster. I'm not going to reveal it yet, but once I've done that with it, then I will. I want to see if I'm actually having a good time. Maybe I'll try and get some health on purpose on the stage. It's maybe a good time to do a barrel roll. There we go, it works there. How is that? Yeah, boy. One down. Knight 6, cool. Let's try and get 95 plus. I think there used to be a threshold to get unlocks and things. Thank you. There's such a good Panzer Auto's got a few good stages. One of the ones is like an aerial battle against a fleet. It's such a good stage. It's unbelievable. Really, really, really good stage. One of the greats of the series. And probably my second favorite track of the series in it, and one of the boss fights is just incredible. Saga's got the best music, but Auto's got some good stuff. Three, two, one, go. Oh, yeah, it worked out. You just gotta say it and then it voice commands. Look at the quality, there's contrast in there. I haven't heard this music. Aiming sound is actually an option. Wow, okay. It's basically like this, yeah. They might have the three different forms they have in two, where you can select between like bruiser form or like agile form, where you can dash, I think, to avoid attacks. Yeah, you might be able to go fast, slow, and normal speed, I think. And you've got the different forms, I believe. Like, and you've probably got berserk, because that's a major part of the series, except for just not in this one, where you charge up energy from doing lots of lock-ons. And then you can just go mental and it'll just constantly fire lasers at and auto-target everything. Which there's usually a section in each stage where they feel like you need to use that because it gets so hectic. It's such a good effect that you can be used in res as well. Those are the only, yeah, I think the speed up slow down thing is the one thing that's new in auto. This, you just fly through the stages like this and you get a good point range. And the one cool thing is, one of the best things in design in Saga, which I think is like preempted a lot of games doing it, like WoW, where enemies all flash red zones on the screen where they're going to do a big attack, and then you have to like, you know, turn or move to avoid it. That is in like a mainstay in MMOs now, and I just feel like Panzer did that way before all that. Sure, some games have done it even before that, but it was really cool in Saga. You're just like, oh, I need to tactically get weak point attacks, but at the same time avoid like these zones at exactly the right time so that you can like push into, you know, the edge of getting hit. So they kind of do that, I think, in Water, even though it doesn't play as well, because you can't move. Well, you can boost, yeah, I'm sure they do that, because you can use a boost to go to the front of an enemy. So there are, there's some new stuff, but you're not going to be... It's not like Saga, where if you get thrown into that, it's, there's a hell of a lot of RPG stuff going on. Oh, nice. This was, I remember listening to the trailer, it's an iconic video, where the worms did not look good. Like, Sandworms jumping through the desert. It's just like, wow, this game is going to be... You know, this is the next generation of consoles, basically, at the time. And me learning you can actually shoot the green stuff, I thought it was good, because it takes a few shots. Shooting it, you know, you just have to take the damage all the time, because you can't really seem to avoid it. So I'll go over the special boost on this now, because they've done it on Twitter, but it's not... They're not like a manual, they tell you. So basically, at any time, if you tap a direction, then tap it again, but hold it the second time, he does a fast dash, so you can dodge attacks more effectively, like that. And then, to both use triggers to do like turn 90 degrees, like I'm doing all the time. If you hit them both together, it does 180 degree turns, so you don't have to do it twice. And then barrel roll is double tap a direction. But on this version, you have to be on low health to do it. I don't remember if you did before, I don't think so. Not as helpful as you think. Gimmick and anything else. They obviously saw Star Fox and said, yeah, we need some of that. Uh-oh. Gun sound is not bad, but I feel like it's a little off. That really felt like dead on for me. Presumably in auto there's probably different routes. I don't remember that actually, but in Zavai that was a big thing, that was one of the main things people loved about the games. It's like at certain points where it looks like there's two routes, you've got a hold left or right and you're going that way. I'm not sure if they have. Good game anyway, so it's not good. The good news is that apparently, well, I don't know, they said from sales, it looks like they're definitely going to do Remaster of 2, which is going to be insane, that game will sell, right? I think this one obviously is quite short, you know, if you played Metal Shooter before, although it's been good news, I guess not. Like, killer. New stuff, right? Gameplay-wise, but 2 is amazing. See you, buddy. Because you played Rez, haven't you? But on that game, you can play it on a mode where you literally can't die, can't you? I'm not saying you did that, but that was an actual option in the game. Oh, 90% garbage. You are a rubbish player. Please quit now. Can't make me. Alright. Probably jinxed it, but I feel like I'm coughing less on these streams. Yesterday was ludicrous. It's funny, I always hear about these things about you saying you're bad at games. Well, we were having fun at Horizon. Man, you've done some feats. Like finishing Croc, like, especially with all the gems, is just... That's when I'm going to have to say I'm bad at games, because goddamn. Just, I felt absolutely brutal. I think I'm quite impatient, that's why. You got like ice stages, and I'm trying to run around and quickly finish it, and you just die. There is some bad hit detection as well, but you just get used to that as a kid, I guess. There's some comically bad hit detection we've seen in the industry. Those bombs on hard hit ludicrously hard. I think they might have patched it, actually. They said they were going to. Like, it takes off about a quarter of your health for each one, so by the time you've got past this one ship, you're nearly dead. It's insane. Yeah, you're not paying attention. Might be intentional, but they did say they're going to change some of the damage ratios. Yeah, exactly. You do need to like sit out and look at it in hands. Yeah, which is not how I'm playing too much Sonic to tell me to not do that. Even the old Sonic 1 was very much so. Don't play too fast the game, which is surprising, but obviously if you played it, you know. Got him, that's good. That's one way to not get 100% is to not kill that. Not easy to do, really. Not too bad again. There we go. Good, alright. Yeah, it was, wasn't it? Yeah, Jesus. I never played it when I was a kid, but yeah, I heard it was hard. Man, I'm not kidding. Like, some nightmare levels. One was especially crippling, I don't know, but the other ones were hard. But the road bits, a lot of the auto-scrolling sections in two, we were like in a cart, and that was horrible. Just, I think because I was trying to get wherever the reward was, getting the points or beating everyone. So I don't know, it was just really, really difficult and horrible. The good thing was that Crash, although it's hard, it was designed well, it didn't feel like the game was being rubbish or anything. It felt like you were making mistakes and such a kind of thing. And because it wasn't like all 3D all the time, you weren't constantly jumping at angles trying to land on the platform and kind of severe landing and stuff like that. It was pretty reasonable. That's the odd section. Like the bridge section is a crime against humanity and the UN should have banned it from being solved, but apart from that, maybe they did. And obviously, the stormy ascent is horrible, but they explicitly warn you when you download that this is a horribly difficult level. You shouldn't play. We've cut this content for a reason. I'll do badly here, I'm supposed to let the end get past like that. Oh no! What the hell? Oh. Must be some interference. My controller just started drifting to the right there. What's going on in my room? I just having like had interference with Unreal as well. This is weird. I guess it'd be my keyboard's wireless. I guess it's just all the wireless stuff going on. It's not often though. It's just occasionally. You see it like just drift. Actually, I have got drift on one. Yeah. Switch controller, but not this one. This is the Pro controller. Not the obviously drift-based ones that they put. New feature on the console. So. These guys are a pain in the butt. So it's bombs go hard. They seem to launch a lot. Oh wow! Okay. Wow, yeah, I wonder if I have thrown a controller. I probably have thrown it like onto a couch or a bed or something, but not in recent memory. I tend to be quite chill. Well, I don't get quite chill. I tend to swear at games a lot. I just don't throw things. M++, which is one of my favourite games I've made, is, it just keeps getting harder and harder to the point where there's some levels it's just not worth attempting. I've got platinum, but there's still like 150 other levels you can do that are harder than that. It's just not worth it. Like, I swear so much. That's funny enough, that's one of the ones I was talking about where I got it, even though I have it digitally, I bought it physically because the non-patched version is actually better, which is really bizarre. Literally the best music track in the game has been taken out by a patch, which is just crushing, because that's one we always listen to, so luckily I've got it on discs and stuff like that. I thought I could use Spotify, but it's kind of weird. It's just... I remember when that happened, we were like, are we doing something wrong? Like, why can't I find the music track in the game that is obviously in the game? It's not mentioned on patch notes, they're just like, nah, I don't know. Yeah, yeah. No doubt. I would say that. You don't swear at someone that annoys you because you have empathy and they're actually people who it'll get to them and they'll react to it, so the computers are there so you can swear at them and just go, what the hell? Finally, something that might be. Gaming frustrations out somehow. No, those missiles come back if you don't shoot them, so you can hit them back. On hard, you don't let that happen. That's really nice. Quick turn? Yeah, it works for it. Good. Oh, this bit's weird. Sometimes it seems to let you damage it a bit earlier. I'm not making that up. Sometimes it's just something that's pretty fun. Like, I feel like you can get its health lower than this before you get to this point. So let's just go get a hip somewhere. Now I should be able to hit again. Now. There we go. This last bit of the balance of art, because you're not really going to die, it's just going to be an edge. That's it, more enemies after I kill them. Right. It's good that they have that, the enemies behind you, because in the next start of the stage, they seamlessly can... Yes, 100%! It seamlessly continues and they are behind you, if this is the tunnel level, which I think it is. By voice control anymore. Come on, episode 4. Hurry up, John. Got a new motor. Wow, this is a bad one. I guess it's just like loading into RAM and that, but it's amazing how much there is loading times when obviously the whole thing is installed, like onto the card. Jesus, has it gone wrong? Uh oh. Wow, that was a really long load. Yeah, so that's still that's cool. Behind you, unless you, I think there's other ones behind me as well. Sure. Yeah, there we go. A lot better than my first stream of this. I lost a ton of health immediately last time. Oh yeah, oh nice, I should have hit next time because he wasn't ready for that. Yes, you are absolutely. I was literally just about to say that. I think I said it on the original stream. But if this is the level design you like, there's so much of this in Saga. That's where all this like ancient technology design shows up a lot. There's kind of, I think if I remember right, there's almost too many of those. But there's loads of experience like these rooms. It's just beautiful. They're much better. Like, it's hard to say better graphics design because obviously it's on the sound, it's not the lowlights. But there's lots of animated lights. Things moving around on the walls, and that just it really striking. So yeah, everyone like Saga if they played probably, but if you like this design especially, one day I'll do. So it's like, I'll have like a week off or something. I'll just get into it. It's just pretty long. It's like 40 plus hours. There's one thing I never did, there's lots of rare enemy spawns as well, which I only found a couple of them. So you probably need about 100 hours if you want to get every enemy in the mystery as well. Here we go. Most hated boss. Actually, it's been good with shooting. If you got rapid fire enabled, it's alright. Oh no, he's doing that. Good. Good, we're good. Yeah, we're doing alright. Much easier on normal, it seems like a billion health. No, Jeez, that seems harder than ever. Maybe you just avoid those. Do it well. At least I hit something. Crazy, I'm almost not getting hit. It's amazing how much change. I wonder how much the patch has affected it. Hey, I thought it was gone. Because it's crazy how much easier this is than it was. Just take hits here. Okay. Cool. Very nice. It's fine. You've seen a good portion of it. Listening out for the music, I guess. And the inspired commentary by Legend. It's a very synth based interpretation. Look at that, it seems like, I wonder if there's a mode where it can just load them all in and you go through the whole game, because that's so close to being a seamless transition between levels there. It's like, straight away you're going to be turned that way facing that airship and shooting. It's just, it's very nice. It's a shame it has to load. Let's see what's going on here. Nothing much, okay. Cool means, right. So episode 5, so obviously you're going to be in the jungle here. This is the one where you're flying above the jungle and there's just countless enemies in the sky. This is a prime example. There's a bit in this level where berserk mode is normally used in Panzer, where there's just enemies from every, just, you know, a lot of fast moving enemies coming in. Come on, son. Right, here we go. That wasn't too bad. Let's go. Radar is so helpful, it's just showing you enemies. Just there you go. It's not much of an after one of this one, because you're just flying over the landscape. Oh, this is bad. This is one of the few bits on the hard way. You're probably going to be attacked on both sides, so you're almost certainly going to take a hit. Very difficult. This coming. There, that's about, I don't know how fast you can do that. You're going to constantly hit now because the iron balls they use are quite nice. Even if they explode near you, get hit. So you can shoot them, but you can shoot them at any point in place. So this is a lot harder, probably dead. Thank you. hard to move those cameras below. So I think it's just overall it's going to be more effective, but probably you know, be able to do a better job. But because I'm used to this, it really felt wrong if you do it. It's good that it's an option. Oh, may die. Right. Right, here we go. Oh, I've not heard this one. At that range you seem to be alright, so then I start closing in, that's good design, isn't it? Stay away so you don't have to, like, shoot all the balls. Come on, kill the bomb. Yes, that's it. Oh, see, I just got hit, because that would not happen if I was on the farm. It's just silly. Uh-oh, I might just use those. Good thing is, the other boats. Flanches, I hope they're a good word for those like spread out bits. More of a big thing in Panzer than they are in this remake. I could be wrong. I feel like I recognise them from a lot of the other ones. Panzer pistol guns. I think I remember the image from the series. Of all time. Of all time. Have some loading. Episode 6, did I just say? This is a brutal level to not take hits. I don't know how many, if it's possible to flawless this, but I'm sure people already know how to do it. Especially at the start, you're immediately almost taking hits from your left, like before you've even had, You've just got control of the dragon. It's like, oh, I'm being hit. Come on, I need. There we go, right. Let's go. Like that, I think actually. Yeah, the bullets come in here. The second after you. There's a lot of targets here as well, haven't they? Which I don't have, but I'm getting 100%. You've got to work out which one you're actually shooting, I guess, is the main thing. I guess the idea is to ignore the main dragon card, because obviously you're going to die. It's just fun to shoot. Look at my health. Criminal. Probably not. I like this music, it feels quite different to the original. Oh, I've got no health, see if I can do barrel roll. Yes! Cool, at least we got to see that. It's quite janky, but probably was, but I'm not sure it's the same. Yeah. Where's the VR mode so you can just throw up the VR? I guess that would work. Res does. Going out on PC, I'm surprised to see it. It's just the constant moving forwards, it's a bit brown, I guess. And you wouldn't really be able to put it behind you too well because of the way ahead, so it's whatever. It'd be nice if you can climb. You look the direction you're pushing, that'd be sweet. Uh oh, that's gonna kill you. Okay, towards the end of the middle. I have to remember the boss being actually okay. Good luck getting 100% of this, just trying to slip off. Oh, I hit a bridge! Terrible. Continue, please. Well, at least we'll have full health. So. Got batter there. Abu. Just want to try and complete this in an hour. As I was showing here by losing those enough. Thank you. I guess it could be even cool if there's like an enemy that binds you or something. So you can't turn for a little bit. My health is criminal. I think I'm trying to do a good job. Is it big dragon man? Oh god. Cool. Alright, excellent. Right. There we go. Let's go. Finale. Come on, son. Oh, yeah. Yeah, VR version, yeah. Be a tough one for sure. Because you're constantly moving forward. I think in res it was okay. There's parts where it goes bad. No, actually, in res it was good. Sorry, the VR level they created in res is very good. But they also let you play VR the original missions of the game, like, which would be the same as this. And that is bad. Like, I don't like it. First bit is really difficult to weather the attacks up. We can get a good attack. These guys suck. Wow, lucky that's what you want to be doing. That's what usually happens with trouble. Damn this game. Thank you. that and it tells me. Good, alright, we're doing it. So we can get rid of the tail spin. Good. He nearly always goes close. Maybe not, I don't know. Okay. Oh, don't charge up already. Crap, I think you're supposed to kill him before this goes off. Well, I'm probably not going to. So on hard, you get to fight him a second form, but it's very a letdown. It's just him again with his like normal attacks. That's not. It's less exciting than the previous form. It's just not a good way to do it. Like, it's brilliant to have an extra fight on hard, but it's just nothing basically. Just a completely normal boss fight. Sharpshooter. I think Dragoon is one of the highest ones. I might be making that. All right, we did it. I mean, it's obviously going to. It's on normal, but. So there you go, that's the new music. I think I actually prefer the other music tracks. These are cool, for sure, but the other ones just, I guess I'm nostalgic for them and they have the... Just grew up with them and they are attached to Panzer Dragoon for me, obviously. This track is really good, anyway. Da 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 da. Well, I don't think I'm going to show the credits again. If you want to see the credits of the game, they're on the other VOD. So I'm just going to skip them here. Alright. That is it. Huzzah. What have we got finished on? Hard. Oh, trying to finish on easy doesn't seem really worth it. Try the code once more to get the other menu, just in case. No? Okay, it's not working for some reason. Alright. Oh, with that shadow. Right! I guess that all that's left to say then is thank you very much for watching, and we'll catch you next time on Channel Olicon. Bye!